And welcome to my channel Engineering Made Simple. Now we were discussing control systems engineering. Now in control systems engineering, in the last class we studied what is the concept of transfer function and what is the concept of block diagram representation of a closed loop control system. Now we will derive a simple derivation, and we will derive. So this definition is titled derivation is titled as derivation of transfer function of a closed loop system in its simpler canonical form. Now as you can see, this is a closed loop control system because it has a feedback. Now why it is known as simple or canonical form? Because there is only one block present in the forward path, that is the straight line path from the input node to the output node, which is the forward path, and in that only one block is present. And in the feedback path also only one feedback element or feedback block is present, and there is only one summing junction and only one takeoff point. So that's the reason this closed loop system is known as known to be in its simple form or canonical form, because it has only one summing junction, one takeoff point, one feedback element, and one forward path gain in the forward path. So we will understand what each of these terms are. Now everybody knows what is C of S. C of S is your controlled output or the output of the Laplace transform of the output of the control system. R of S is the reference input signal applied, that also the signal is applied after taking the Laplace transform. And we are interested in finding the overall transfer function of this closed loop system. Now as we discussed in the previous class, whenever we have a closed loop system given, we can find the overall transfer function using block diagram reduction rules. So before discussing block diagram reduction rules, to reduce more complicated systems and find its overall transfer function, we will first understand how will you derive the transfer function of a closed loop system which is in its simple or canonical form. Because as you can see, because of only one element present over here, this to derive transfer function of such a system is very much easy. So in order to be able to derive overall transfer function of a closed loop control system in complicated case, we will first need to understand how it is done for a simple case or canonical form first. So let us start discussing it. Now we discussed C of S and R of S. And here what does this G of S signify? G of S signifies for, it is the Laplace transform, it is the equivalent forward path, equivalent forward path transfer function, because we discussed this block represents a transfer function. And why it is forward path transfer function, individual transfer function? Because this element is present in the forward path. Similarly, what is H of S? Now H of S is nothing but equivalent feedback path transfer function. Okay, and what is B of S? That is the output obtained after the signal passes through the feedback element or feedback transfer function H of S. So that is denoted by B of S. So that signal is known as your feedback signal, Laplace transform of feedback signal. In any circuit diagram, in any block diagram in control system, if you see S in the bracket, that means that it is a control system. It is in S domain. So B of S is nothing but Laplace transform of feedback signal. Why feedback signal? Because after passing through this feedback element, we get this signal. So Laplace transform of the feedback signal B of T. Why B of T? Because it was in time domain, but in control system block diagram representation, and we want to find the transfer function, that's why we have taken Laplace transform of each and every signals present in the circuit over here. So this is nothing but Laplace transform of feedback signal B of T, and this is equivalent forward path transfer function G of S. And if I want to represent the same transfer function in time domain, this would be nothing but G of T, because it is in the time domain. And when we take the Laplace transform, we get the equivalent forward path transfer function, which is G of S. And similarly is the case with this one. Feedback power transfer function in the time domain is your h of t. And if you take Laplace transform, we get h of s. And we are interested in this interested in signals only in Laplace transform domain because we are discussing transfer function. Now what is transfer function? C of s upon R of s. So its definition only states that it is transfer function is nothing but it is the Laplace transform of the output to the Laplace transform of the applied input. So that's the reason the intermediary signals are also taken in the Laplace domain. Now let us understand another term, E of S. So what is E of S over here? So E of S is nothing but the error signal, Laplace transform of error signal. So this is LT of Laplace transform of the error signal E of T. So here you can see this is the error signal. What does the error signal do? It compares the output which is tapped from over here, that is, and then we get a equivalent feedback signal B of S, and then it is compared. What is E of S? It is nothing but R of S minus B of S. Now notice one interesting thing over here. The polarity of summing junction you notice. So it is plus or minus. So here minus is present at the feedback point over here, feedback junction. So this minus sign represents that this is a closed loop control system, but it is having a negative feedback. So whatever transfer function we are deriving, that is for a negative feedback control system. Same derivation can be done with for positive feedback control system also. That I will discuss briefly. So only polarity changes there in that case. So these are the different signals, and now we will proceed with the derivation. Now let us start deriving the transfer function of a closed loop system with negative feedback. So consider negative feedback case. Now we will first compute the error signal. What is the error signal? Error signal is nothing but R of S. So this is our applied input, applied reference input minus B of S, because the polarity present over here is minus at the summing junction, at the feedback path. So this is the signal we get, that is B of S is nothing but Laplace transform of the feedback signal. So R of S minus B of S will be the signal which will be present at this point in the circuit. So it is nothing but R of S minus B of S. Observe the polarity of the summing junction, and then you will come to know why E of S is R of S minus B of S. So that signal is present over here. And please note the direction of signal flow over here. I have mentioned it clearly. So this is nothing but E of S is nothing but R of S minus B of S. So label it as equation number 1. Now next, B of S, that is the Laplace transform of the feedback signal. So this is B of S. Now we want to find the value for B of S. So what is B of S? B of S is nothing but, so this is the takeoff point. So here, so at this node, C of S is only present, and part of the output is fed back over here. So that's the reason B of S is nothing but C of S into the transfer function in the feedback path. What is the transfer function in the feedback path? H of S. So that is nothing but C of S into H of S. Equation number 2. Label it as equation number 2. So I hope you understood this. Because this is the output node, here also C of S is present, I will write it clearly. So, and then it passes through the feedback path and it encounters your feedback path transfer function. So what is B of S? B of S is nothing but C of S into H of S. So that label it as equation number 2. Now at this point. So at this point also output is C of S. And at the final output node is also your output C of S. So what is this C of S we are interested in finding? Now observe carefully the forward path over here. What you can say about C of S? C of S is nothing but E of S into G of S. Because whenever the input signal passes from input to output, it passes through this forward path. And in this forward path transfer function G of S is present. and error signal which we have computed by R of s minus B of s present. So what will be C of s naturally? It would be nothing but E of s into G of s. Yes. Observe the path over here. So this signal is present over here, and this is the forward path transfer function which is denoted by G of s. So E of s into G of s is nothing but the multiplication of these two will only come at the output node. That's why it is E of s into G of s. Now let us start deriving it further. Now put the value of E of s. So B of s obtained in equation number 2. Obtained in equation number 2 in equation 1. So I will start writing over here so that it would be pretty much clear. Now here in this case, now what I have told, substitute the value of B of s obtained in equation number 2 in equation number 1. So what is our equation number 1? So equation number 1 is given by E of s is equal to R of s minus B of s, but we are going to substitute the value of B of s which I have obtained in equation number 2. So what is B of s? It is nothing but C of s into H of s. So let us write it down. Now let us simplify it even further. So okay, and what is E of s? Value of E, okay, so this is E of s is nothing but R of s minus C of s into H of s. Okay, that's pretty much clear now. So now here we have found out, now E of s is nothing but R of s minus B of s. Now the B of s value we have substituted from equation number 2. So till now I hope this is pretty much clear. Now in the next step, now what is the value of E of s, what can you say about this particular value? So now we want to substitute E of s because we want to find the transfer function C of s upon R of s. So our ultimate aim in this derivation is to find C of s upon R of s. So for that I also need C of s to the right hand side. So for that what I need to do, observe this third equation over here. In that I have the value of C of s with me. What is C of s? C of s is nothing but E of s into G of s. But now I am interested in finding the substitution for E of s. So what will be E of s from this equation number 3? So E of s I want. So E of s will be nothing but C of s upon G of s. C of s upon G of s. Okay. So and the rest thing remains as it is. Now by rules of normal mathematics, this G of s we can multiply it to the right hand side over here. So after multiplying it to the right hand side, we get C of s is nothing but R of s into G of s. Note that we have multiplied it to the right hand side. C of s, H of s and G of s. So please note we have multiplied it, the denominator term, to the right hand side. So it is simple mathematics. So the equation becomes C of s is equal to R of s into G of s minus C of s into H of s into G of s. So this is our equation. So I will write it more clearly over here. So this is nothing but minus C of s into H of s into G of s. So after multiplying this is pretty much clear now. Now we are interested in finding C of s upon R of s. So let us start finding that. So this term is multiplied with C of s. So let us take it to the left hand side. So C of s is plus C of s into H of s into G of s is equal to R of s into G of s. So this is pretty much clear because I have shifted this term, that is C of s into H of s into G of s, to the left hand side. So here it was minus, so this term adds up over here because the term moves from left hand side to right hand side. So now we have the term called as C of S plus C of S into H of S into G of S is equal to R of S into G of S. And we are interested in finding the transfer function, which is nothing but C of S upon R of S. So for that, I will take C of S common from the left hand side. So it would be 1 plus G of S into H of S. Okay. Now here in this case, and this will remain as it is. R of S into G of S. Now observe closely over here. So here C of S I have taken common. Here R of S is present in the right hand side. So C of S is present in the left hand side and R of S is present in the right hand side. So we can simply write C of S upon R of S. But we will take R of S to the denominator. We can write it as G of S upon by our normal mathematics rules. So as you can observe, our derivation is now complete and it is for the negative feedback closed loop system in its simple or canonical form. So it is nothing but it is very simple derivation. So C of S upon R of S is the transfer function we calculated. From the block diagram only we calculated, and in cases where complicated block diagrams are there, that is whenever the your overall closed loop control system is not given in simple or canonical form, in that case we need to learn the block diagram reduction rules, which I will cover in the next lecture. But for time being, this is the derivation which we directly computed from the block diagram with the knowledge of signals and our normal mathematics we calculated. Now this was for negative feedback system, this derivation. Now if I want to do the same derivation but for a closed loop system with positive feedback, so what will be the changes? Have a closed loop over here. So the polarity of this summing junction will change. Now this polarity will be also positive. Now because of that, your error signal will be nothing but R of S plus B of S. So considering now a positive feedback case, so I will replace this plus with minus. So now here, this is positive feedback case. Now what will be the error signal? You only tell me. This is the applied reference input. So and this is the feedback signal. But now polarity is positive because it is a positive feedback system. So error signal is nothing but R of S plus B of S because of the plus sign present at the summing junction. So this is R of S plus B of S. So B of S remains the same, which is nothing but C of S into H of S. Similarly, there is no change in the third equation. Now we let us move on to the next step. Now put the value of B of S obtained in equation 2 in equation 1, just as in the previous case. But have a close look over here. So in earlier case, what was our R of S? E of S, equation 1, it was R of S plus B, R of S minus B of S. But in this case, it is because of the positive feedback, it is R of S plus B of S. So it would be replaced by plus. So again in the next step, it would be replaced by plus because you can see E of S is nothing but R of S plus B of S in this case, and the substitution for B of S I have done. So what is B of S? Is nothing but C of S into H of S. So this is how you get the next step. And now wherever minus is there, you will replace it with plus. Now because here plus sign was present, now when you take this term, that is C of S into H of S into G of S, because of positive feedback, you take it to the left, this plus sign will be replaced by minus sign. So now here in this case, in this derivation, now we can say here plus sign will be represented by minus sign. So minus sign will be replicated in the denominator. So this particular transfer function is for your positive feedback. And if somebody asks you to derive for negative feedback, the same earlier explanation you have to follow, but the transfer function will be G of S upon 1 plus G of S H of S for negative feedback. So this is the derivation for transfer function for negative feedback. So this is the equation which we get. Now for complicated systems, we are going to learn how to compute overall transfer function of complicated closed loop systems using block diagram reduction rules, but that we will cover in the next lecture. So that's all for the today.